Hi friends, today's lesson is for Module 5, Lesson 2. Friends, I am so glad you're here today because I had the worst trouble when I went to the laundromat. I mean, I was just walking out and dropped all of my socks on the floor. I was like, oh my goodness, I should probably count them and make sure they're all there. So I'm gonna go ahead and count. Can you count with me, friends? Oh, thank you. Here we go. I'm gonna put a check mark on all of them as I count, okay? Just to keep myself organized, there's a lot of socks. Let's go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Okay, I have 10, and then I have three more over here. How can I talk about this group of socks? Oh man, what are we gonna do? Oh, I know. We could think about today's lesson. Our learning goal for today says, I can describe a group of objects as 10 ones and blank ones. So, okay, I'm going to think about my socks. Let's describe them as 10 ones because I see there's 10 socks and then some ones. So, let me see. Let me write that down. 10 ones and blank ones. Let's see. I see this group of 10 that I made because I did the check marks on the 10. How many ones do I have left over, friends? Yeah, go ahead and count them. One, two, three. So I could say in this group of socks from the floor, I get 10 ones and three more ones. Perfect. Hey, thanks for helping me describe these socks. Oh, goodness. Can you help me with this other pile over here, though? Oh, those white socks got everywhere. All right, so what should I start with? How am I going to figure out how many socks I have? Yes, thank you. I need to count them, right? Let's try to find a group of 10 and let's go ahead and put a check mark on them as we go through. That way I know which ones I've counted, okay? Count with me, friend. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. All right, there's my group of 10, but oh, for Pete's sake, what about these socks? I know how to describe them. I could say 10 ones and blank ones. So I have 10 ones here in my group of 10s. How many ones do I have left over? Yeah, two ones. So I could say my white socks, in the group of white socks, I had 10 ones and two ones. Perfect. Hey, thanks for your help. Okay, I have one more stack of socks. Can you help me with these? Okay, who put them in that fancy circle? Who was it? Probably Miles. Okay, let's go ahead and what are we going to do? How are we going to start this? How am I going to figure out how to describe the group of socks that I have? Oh, you think we should count them? Perfect. How am I going to keep myself organized when I'm counting so many socks? Oh, thanks. Yeah, let's put a check on them. All right, let's go ahead and count. As we count this time, you put a check on them with your finger in the air. It'll be so funny. Here we go. One, two. Are you making your check in the air? Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. All right, there's my group of 10. I'm done. I had 10 in my group. Wait, what? I'm not done? Why not? Can't I just say there were 10 pink socks? No, there's more than 10, right? All right, oh, you're so smart. Let's use our good describing sentence. 10 ones and blank ones. I know the ones that were in the group of 10 I checked off. How many ones were left over that I didn't check off? Four. So I could say I have 10 ones and four ones because I have my group of 10 and I have four more, right? Oh, this is perfect. I am so glad that this lesson happened today when I made a big mess with my laundry. Because it's really helpful because our learning goal said I can describe a group of objects as 10 ones and some more ones. That's exactly what we did. All right, thank you. You know, you did such a good job. I want you to go ahead and for your exit ticket, I'm going to have you seesaw and tell me about these socks. All right, so I already put the check on the 10, and then I know that there's some that were not checked. So I want you to go ahead and finish the sentence. So on your dry erase board, go ahead and write 10 ones and blank ones. Then you look at the picture and fill in how many ones are going to go in that empty spot. I can't wait to see what I should have you do describing tens and ones like I did and how you helped me throughout this whole lesson. right, good luck, friends.